right, the Reds were in the old bank in Liverpool, James Street in Liverpool, just watched the match. The Reds have won 5-0. Mo Salah scored a world-class goal and gave us a world-class assist as well. And 5 is well better than 4. Bobby got a hat-trick at the end as well. And perfect. One that you said to me before, you hate these kick-offs because like, you sort of really punctuate your weekend in one way or another. So if you fuck up, you're like, well, what's everyone else going to do? It's fucking your weekend.
Yeah, I think we started really, really brightly in this game, and Mo Salah was on it from the first minute to the game. I think I said the first 5 minutes. This has got like, reminds me a little bit of the start of being Arsenal in 2013-14. And Mo just looked really, really on it from the first minute. And I think you're right, Gareth. I think a game like this, they're a bit trappy. I have loads of reasons why we could have talked ourselves into having a mare today. But to win in the manner that we did, absolutely convincing from the first minute. Again, a little bit proper getting the ball to go, I thought we had loads and loads of chances to murder these. To keep the clean sheet, to extend our brilliant goal difference, and put a bit of pressure back on all the other teams. Like, I know we're only small things, but like, we played today without our first two goalkeepers.
Lots of hot buns
in the oven.
I mean, George, one of the things we're going to be talking about is it sort of felt set up that to be a banana skin. Like, Bob was fuming yesterday about Curtis Jones, about Fabinho, about the goalie, about international football. And like, you just thought, I enjoy it when he's spiky, but I also thought, well, what's the move going to be like? Would they all be feeling sorry for themselves? But absolutely not.
It's so true, and I completely convinced myself. I've turned myself to a massive shithouse this morning as well. I was looking at so many aspects, and you know, the narrative was already written. It was a hard to call kickoff, which no one enjoys. You've got Ranieri, who's come back big this first game from Watford as well. You've got players out, you've got the Brazilians not able to play. Curtis Jones gets injured. I mean, the midfield picked itself today. We were looking on many other options.
It's just a lad who could walk.
Absolutely, yeah. And then, you know, you pick up all those narratives and all the things that could potentially be wrong. Salad does not give a solid and shiny shape on you and your narrative, but he just come out and put them away on his own in the first 10 minutes. And I think, like, the first 10 minutes, he hit the bar, he'd had a shot which was blocked for a corner, he'd almost created an assist, he'd sat people down already. He's just a phenomenal player, and to watch him, how fortunate we are to get a player right at the peak of his powers, it's just absolutely unbelievable. We're very lucky, and I can't wait to see him for the rest of the season, because he's going to be playing the he might even be European football of the year.
I'll just go and check on Danny Rose there, just to see how he is and if he's alright, and maybe if he just needs a little bit of a cuddle, because I think he's going to have Mo Salah burnt on the inside of his eyelids when he's trying to get to sleep tonight. But we're going to enjoy talking about all of that and more in the Most Match Fight. Get on it, subscribe to the Anfield app, and up the fucking Reds, 5-0, get it!
To get full access to this show, click on the link in the post and subscribe to Talk Premium. You get all of our content, including previews, reviews, post-match content, exclusive interviews, and loads of transfer chats. So subscribe to the Anfield Wrap now. We share the journey of supporting Liverpool from heart of the city.